Hey guys, our devotion comes this week from the song Here Again by Elevation Worship. I really love this song, but last week I was really thinking, I was like, what should I do? And I was looking through my playlist on my phone, and I was like, what song speaks to me, and what song should I do? And so I want it to be the perfect devotion. And I was like, well, I don't know what to do. So like, maybe I shouldn't do a song. Maybe I shouldn't do anything. Like, maybe this is me, like, God tell me, like, Haley, like, you're not enough. Like, you just don't need to do this. And I was like, maybe I just need to text Nori and just tell him, like, hey, I'm sorry, but, like, I can't do this right now. Like, maybe someone else needs to do it. Like, leave this to you and Hannah and Jackson. Let y'all do it. It's like, y'all know so much more than me, and I just don't have the words to say. Like, who am I to talk about this? Like, I don't know. And at that moment, I really felt God saying to me that he was like, Haley, you're not enough. And you're not supposed to be enough. And you're never going to be enough. But I am enough. With me, you are full. He brings everything that I am not. I don't know everything. And I just feel a lot of times that I just feel empty. And the thing is, like, he is so full. And he is always wants to meet me where I'm at. Like the song Here Again says, I'm not enough unless you come when you meet me here again. And by myself, I am not enough. I will never be enough. With God, I am enough. And that's just really hard for me to even comprehend, because for a long time, I've really been just dealing with emotions that, like, I'm not enough. I'm not good enough. I'm not pretty enough. I'm not smart enough. Like, who would ever, like, I'm not enough. And that was, like, with the world. And I feel like sometimes I bring that over to God and I pretend that he thinks the same way. And, like, that's a complete opposite. Like, God knows I'm not enough because he knows that I am not perfect. But with him, I am enough and I can be enough. And he will give me the right words to say. And he meets me where I'm at all the time. And I don't have to be anybody or anything that I'm not. And that for so long, I felt like that's all I've tried to be, is someone that I'm not. I've tried to be this person, or I've tried to be this leader, or this person that I'm not. And I can come to Jesus with my flaws, my insecurities, and my sins, and he'll still meet me where I'm at. He still meets me where I need it. And a lot of times, I don't even know where I need it, but he meets me there because I just feel him. And that's what I love about God, is I don't have to change. It's just, that's just the craziest thing for me, is that God loves me and he can see everything that I've ever done and things I haven't done. And he loves me despite everything. He meets me in my brokenness. He meets me in my unbelief. He meets me in my frustration, in my anger, in my sorrow, and in my sadness. I find myself a lot of times thinking about God as like a God who wants me to be perfect, and I know that's not God, but a lot of times it really gets in the way between me and God and just praying, because I'm like, oh, I can't come to God because I haven't done this or I haven't done that, or I can't come to God because my life's a mess, or I can't come to God because even my room's a mess. And I feel like that's just so crazy to some people, but it's true for me. And I just have to, like, sit back and think. I'm like, God already knows this, and he already knows everything. Like, that doesn't matter to him. Like, he doesn't need me to be perfect. He doesn't need me to know the right words. He doesn't need me to know what to say, because he knows everything. He doesn't need me to say anything at all, because he's going to sit with me in anything. He's going to meet me right where I need him, and he's going to know what I need. In times where my thoughts really drift that way, I find myself really questioning my worth. Oftentimes I feel forsaken, forgotten, and I feel frustrated that I feel that way, because I'm like, I shouldn't be feeling this way, because, like, I'm a Christian, and I should not be feeling forsaken. But, like, the song Here Again says, not for a minute was I forsaken, because the Lord is in this place. And he is. He's always in this place. Because I feel him in my brokenness. I feel him in my emptiness. I feel him in my fullness. I feel him every aspect of my life. Just like in Colossians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10 says, "For in Christ all the fullness of the deity lives in bodily form, and in Christ you have been brought to fullness." Jesus just constantly reminds me that, like, I don't have to be full because he's full. And when I'm not full, he fills me up. When I am faithless, he remains faithful. And when I am questioning, he gives me answers. And he meets me every time, everywhere I need. Even when I don't know the words to say. And even when I feel helpless. And I feel like no one could ever get anything from me. He's still going to meet me. He's still going to show me. And I hope that that's one thing you've learned from this devotion, is that the world may tell you that you have to be perfect and you have to know the right words to say, that you have to be good enough and you have to be enough. But the thing is, you're never going to be enough unless you have God with you. And God is always enough. And he's always going to show you that with him, you are enough.
Can't go back to the beginning. Can't control what tomorrow will bring. But I know here in the middle is the place you promised to be. As I walk now through the valley, let your love rise above every fear. Like the sun shaping a shadow in my weakness, your glory. Forsaken, the Lord is in this place. The Lord is.
Thank you.